Hi guys, I'm so glad that you're back joining me for another process video, and I am hoping that everyone had a wonderful Christmas. And as we're just kind of gearing up for the new year, I thought that I would work through one of the Illustrated Faith workshops that they have in their Print and Pray shop that I have linked below. And this one is the Powerful Prayers Workshop. And the first one that they have you do is a prayer for yourself. And so it is in Joshua chapter 1, verse 8. And I've kind of marked off the whole chapter in Joshua. And I just because I thought it was all really important. And it talks about being strong and being courageous and just trusting in the Lord's word and meditating on it every day. And I just thought that that was a perfect way to kind of gear up for 2018, that just kind of to start preparing our hearts to open our Bible every day and make sure that we're trusting in his word and that we're following his word daily. And with this workshop, you get 4 weeks of content, and there are principles as well as a devotional and prayer. And so the way that it works is that it's kind of Mad Lib style, like when we were kids and you would just kind of fill in the blanks with what you wanted to. And so that's kind of how the prayer is broken down in this workshop. And so I kind of already went through and I cut out the word Fetty, and I put that in the prayer. And then I'm just gonna kind of, you saw me kind of rough up the edges of the prayer just to kind of make it look a little more of that mixed media style. And I have the principles printed on the Avery Clear sticker paper, which I have also linked below. It's the Avery 8665. And it works great. And a lot of people in the Illustrated Faith community and in the Bible journaling community have been using it. And you can see there that I just kind of used it as a faux washi tape at the top of the page. So through this, I'm just kind of cutting out some of the word Fetty. I have the tab that I want to use. I've already cut that out. And that was on the clear sticker paper as well. And I just think that I really liked the way that this page ended up turning out. Just the colors that they have in this workshop, they all work really well together. And so I loved how this page ended up coming out. I think this tab is probably my favorite part of the page. I just love how it kind of has that acrylic paint swipe look to it. And I also love the lettering that is in there. And so what I did is I printed it on the clear sticker paper just because I wanted other elements from the from that entry on the clear sticker paper. But if you do the tab on clear sticker paper and it has the wording on it and then you fold it over, it looks kind of muddy and it doesn't stand out as much. So I just cut it out and then I put it on white cardstock, and then I cut around the white cardstock and I put some adhesive, and so then the tab kind of stands out a little bit and it doesn't stick to itself, and it kind of just makes it look a little bit easier to read, and it kind of makes it stand out a little bit better, which I really like that about that tab. And I've seen lots of washi storage on Instagram and online, and I decide to use my washi on just an embroidery hoop that you guys will see here in just a couple seconds. I find that it's a little bit easier. They're all able to be seen, and I just have them color coded and I can just peel it off right on the ring, and I just have the ring hanging up by my desk so it's easy to grab and easy to see for inspiration and things like that. If you have any other like washi storage breakthroughs, go ahead and put them in the comments below so we can all see what's going on in the washi world, because we all know we love washi tape. And now I'm just using my Illustrated Faith stamp set from the Strong and Courageous kit from last year. And just because that's what it talks about in Joshua chapter 1. And so I definitely wanted that to be part of this entry. And so I'm just using those words as well as some typeface stamps. I believe I got them from Michaels in the Recollections kit, and I'm just using the VersaFine permanent ink. You do want to be careful because it does take a little bit to dry. I made the mistake of not hitting it with my heat tool, and so it does kind of smudge onto my fingers a little bit, and then I touch something down at the bottom, and so there's some black ink from my fingers down at the bottom of my page when it is all finished. And so I just love how the title came out nice and simple, and I just love using stamps because you can use them over and over again. And now I'm using something new that I just got this week. I got some Neo colors, and I got all different colors just to try and see how I liked them. And today I just decided to use them as a crayon and just have some texture onto the page. But I would love to hear how you guys are using Neo colors, just because it is a new medium for me. And so I'm definitely wanting to play with them and kind of try them out. So if you guys have any ideas or any techniques that you guys want me to try, again, put it down in the comments so then I can kind of get some inspiration from you guys and try out some new things. I just loved how these colors kind of matched the workshop printables that were already there. And I just love how it kind of put a little bit of a finishing touch on the page along with my date. And that's gonna do it for today. I hope that you guys enjoyed this simple entry and that it just kind of spoke to your heart. Definitely look into the workshop. It's a lot of fun to work through. I'm gonna be trying to do some process videos, and I'll leave you guys with some close-ups. Be sure to follow me on Instagram at RoWrites. Use the link below to get some awesome products, and I hope you guys have a wonderful day. Goodbye.